Hutchison. Loose ball. Out of bounds to Indiana. Now let's see what Travis Best does with it. Jim Gray tells us that during the timeout, Larry Bird echoed your sentiments, Doug Collins, when he said, look, Travis, don't take it into the lane. Don't dribble the ball too much. Direct traffic out there.
Well, Michael Jordan now is on Reggie Miller. Best on Kerr. He can beat him off the dribble.
So that changes things.
He's dribbling it too much.
He goes to the basket and hits on the run. He's got his own ideas, and sometimes I guess they're the right ideas.
Well, at that time, he was being guarded by Steve Kerr and not Michael Jordan. So he set Steve Kerr up and used his foot speed because he didn't have to go against Jordan's foot speed.
Now, remember, he made the big play in game four to bring him within one, almost on the same kind of play. This kid has got no conscience. Up and off the glass, 33 seconds to go, and he has a two-point lead.
No conscience and no fear. Pacers by two. Larry Bird, the demeanor we've come to expect. The rest of the place is nuts.
Steve Kerr is on the floor because he's a shooter. They've been doubling with Best. Remember game six last year, the Stockton double team, and Kerr hit the shot. Michael has confidence in him. Best must stick to him.
Into Longley it goes. Michael on the move, looks to tie, but can't. Longley grabs it, gets it back to MJ. Into the lane. And it won't drop, but Jordan will come to the line for two free throws that could tie it.
But watch, Antonio Davis reaches in, but Jordan still has the strength to power through the move.
Well, the stone face went away. He finally showed a reaction. Michael needs them both to tie. Halfway there into the teeth of a hostile crowd. Tie game, 35 for Jordan. No timeout, as you predicted. Best to the basket, collides with Rodman. Ball comes loose. A whistle for a foul, and let's see who it's on. Travis Best is 36 of 40 at the free throw line in the playoffs. 8.5 seconds. Got it.
Wow. That was nothing but net.
A 90% guy in the postseason. Hits them both.
So they've gone to a small lineup. He has Dale Davis on him. So Dale Davis has got to be very careful here.
Watch Kukoc on the penetration.
It's Michael. That's the guy to watch. He stumbles and loses it. McKee has it. The Pacers and the Bulls will take it to the limit. Now, wait a second. The officials are saying that there may have been a foul with a second or maybe tenths of a second on the clock. Right now, they have put 0.4 seconds up on the clock.
Make the first one and miss the second one so they can't throw a long pass. If he misses the first one, you've got to make sure that you get that three-point lead. I think you're going to see him here try to miss this shot.
I will put the points on the board right now. I would not miss. Put the points on the board and end the game.
He misses it on purpose. Pippen grabs it, and that will do it. For the first time since the conference semifinals in 1992, Michael Jordan's Bulls, we're not counting when he was gone all of 94, or when he was a shadow of himself in 95 when he came back briefly, the real Michael Jordan Bulls taken to an elimination game for the first time in 6 years.
You see, Bird made the decision to bring McKee back into the game for his defensive ability and also his defensive reputation. He has a defensive reputation, so the officials are not going to call a call on him because he has that reputation.
Well, you could see that he put his right arm down and gave Michael a push, and he lost his balance. Interestingly enough, both finishes we've had, games 4 and 6 here, have ended with a controversial no call.
And let's watch Bird's reaction right here. Again, been there, done that. We got a game 7. Congratulations, guys.
Wow.